Hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder video. We're going to do that same old thing where we look at pictures of what is now been released on the dev server for War Thunder Update 1.79 Project X. Presumably Project X because it is coming to the Xbox One. Finally, now I can stop receiving comments about the Xbox One on my old Xbox One video. But I know last time I actually did a video on the dev server for the first time, even though I did a really bad, poor job on it. I was going to do that this time as well, however, I'm on a laptop and there's a few problems with that. Number one, it would have taken a long time to actually get installed, longer than on my main PC. And second of all, recording War Thunder with this laptop is weird, because while this laptop is very, very good, the problem is War Thunder is very glitchy. For some reason, the graphics card just does not like War Thunder, and it flashes and just zaps and glitches around constantly, unless you're in a game actually playing. Therefore, it's extremely difficult to record. That's why there are no gameplay videos for you guys, even though I have been playing War Thunder on the laptop. So, classic old way, I've been provided with screenshots. All credit goes to the person that has actually provided these to me, among other things. And we're going to take a look at them. We're going to take a look at the vehicles, the new vehicles, reworked and changed models, as well as ammunition and their placement on the tech tree. Keep in mind, though, dev server stuff, things are subject to change. However, there are two other things I wanted to show. No, not that, you twat. This is the Fritz 10, or Fritz X bomb, guided bomb, actually, I believe, which is actually in the game, as far as I've been told, as a usable weapon on the HE-177. I have no idea how that works, but it's a thing. And then second of all, look at this! Look at this! This is a new map for aerialistic battles! Can you believe it? No, I can't. Finally, in years, we're finally getting a new realistic battles map. No idea if it's a good map or not. I don't know. I'm not in the game to look at it, unfortunately. But this is what was provided to me, so, well, there you go. Anyways, we're going to take a look. We'll start with the aircraft. If you want to see the ground vehicles, pop down into the comment section. I should have a pinned comment with a timestamp. Also, I apologize if my voice is a little weird because I am holding on to the microphone right now rather than having it sit somewhere. Okay, I'm going to be reacting to pretty much all of these because I haven't looked at them yet. Let's start off. First one here is the P-40E1 Kitty Hawk. That's not a new plane, but it is a reworked model. So this is an updated and much model, as you can see. Looks fantastic. The only thing I'm worried about with this is the paint schemes, because any time a vehicle gets reworked, it seems like they completely rehash the skins, sometimes removing skins or editing them so much. Like, for example, the paint that's on this right now, the Pacific War camouflage, does not look anything like what we had in the game before, because by default before, it was actually green. I believe. No, there was a green paint scheme. So maybe this is a lot more similar. But I'm curious to see if all the other camouflages are still there or if they've been completely reworked. Remember the A-20G? When that got updated and changed to a different model, they removed that summer camouflage. Oh, that thing is so nostalgic. I wish they'd bring that back. Anyways, very beautiful looking model. Fantastic. Love it. Oh, I can't wait. And of course, the next one is the P-40 F-10, which is the new P-40 variant that they're adding to the game. I already explained my excitement for a new P-40 variant. I've been waiting literally years for new P-40 variants, and while we did get the P-40C, as I stated, that was a premium collectible, so I didn't exactly pass it off as acceptable for a new variant of the P-40. Now we're finally getting a standard research tree P-40, and the two vehicles I wanted variants added of the most were the P-40 and the BF-110. Well, spoilers, apparently the BF-110 is getting two new variants plus a model update. This update is fucking awesome. anyways, so the P-40 F-10 is equipped with 6 12.7mm M2 Browning machine guns with 1,686 rounds at a battle rating of 2.7. That's probably for arcade. Don't know about the other game modes. And the RP cost for this thing is 9,200. So, very, very simple RP cost, very low tier. And here we get to see it on the research tree, so it's actually in a folder at rank 2 with the P-40 E1 Kitty Hawk. Very nice looking. There you go. And if you want to take, if you want to pause it and look at all the specific stats like max speed and stuff, go ahead. But remember, again, lots of this stuff is subject to change, so things can change at any freaking moment. And here we get to see its payload. The P-40F can carry two 100-pound bombs, a 500-pound bomb, or two 100-pound bombs and a 500-pound bomb. So it can help support the ground units. Now here's the next vehicle. This one, I didn't actually know when it was listed to me. I was told the FJ-4B. I have no idea what that plane was, so I looked it up on Google, and apparently it's a jet. And here it is. It was a jet. So the United States are apparently receiving a new naval jet fighter at Battle Ready 9.0. Looks like a, it almost basically, to me, looks like a naval saber. It's got very saberish looks at it, just a little bit more bulky. It's got, yeah, Battle Ready 9.0, research cost of $390,000, not $380,000, so that's something to keep a note of. It's equipped with four 20mm Browning Colt Mark 12 Mod 3 cannons with 576 rounds, and there you can see the other stats. And I'm curious to see, that's probably going to go after the latest on the tech tree. Yeah, it's going to go, oh no, it's actually in the attacker line. So it's a jet fighter, but it's actually in the attacker line. So that's curious. So it comes after the F3D1 on the tech tree. Very, very curious. There you go. So for fans of United States jets, you've got yourself a new one to play with. And I'm sure we're going to, yep, right here. We get to see, what the hell is going on? Okay, we get to see its payload. So it's got a lot to choose from. Six 250-pound bombs, six 500-pound bombs, two 1,000-pound bombs, two 2,000-pound bombs, or 114 Hydra 70 unguided rockets. Holy shit. Wow. Okay, well, there you go. So, again, going to be able to help out quite a bit in combined battles. Okay, and moving on, we get to, of course, look at the BF-109Z, a new German fighter aircraft, which is available currently through a bundle pre-order. Battle rating 4.3, so it's actually a lower battle rating than I was expecting. Now here's something that's curious that was actually pointed out to me before I looked at this. It is a rank 3, not a rank 4. Now if I'm not mistaken, if we go over to the website here and we scroll down and we go to the BF-109Z, this thing is advertised as a rank 4 premium. It says it's right there on the pre-order information. Does it also say it in the development blog? I don't know. If it does, I'm not going to spend the time like looking through all of this quick. I'm just kind of zipping through it. If it does, well, either way, it's currently advertised as a rank 4 premium. And as was pointed out, it's going to suck quite a bit and can be considered false advertisement if people invested money in this for a rank 4 grinder, and then they go and change it last minute to a rank 3 without any official announcement. That's going to be pretty ballsy. And that's going to break a lot of people's balls as well. So right now I'm hoping that maybe this is just a mistake and it's rank 3 on the dev server, but will be rank 4 when it's released on update 1.79 is released. Of course, it's equipped with four 30mm MK-108 cannons. Two wing-mounted and two in each of the nose hubs. So there you go. Nothing really else to say about this vehicle. It's $29.99 currently on the store. You get some Golden Eagles and some other pre-order bonuses and some premium time and stuff. I think it's going to be a really fun plane. I'm mainly getting it because it's fucking amazing looking, and it's a BF-109Z. Again, I already stated my excitement for this vehicle when they did the official dev blog on it. Excuse me for a minute. I'm taking a drink. I have to keep my my gullet nice and liquefied. And what the fuck is all this shit all over my little white things? Okay. Anyways, moving along. There it is on the tech tree. So it's again at rank 3. Hopefully that goes down here in rank 4. I guess we'll find out. We'll have to wait and see. And it does get to carry a single 250-kilogram bomb. Breaking some new grounds there. This thing's mainstay is going to be the 30mm cannons, and I imagine that the 30mm cannons are going to be able to equip the crazy ammunition, which means these things are going to be a fucking bitch to fly, or excuse me, to drive against when the enemy team has them flying around in the air. Okay, moving. Okay. here we go. Now, first of all, let me just explain my excitement for BF-110s, guys. Okay, I seem to be one of the few people, at least back in the day, that actually loved the BF-110. When I made this statement a little while back, a lot of people agreed with me that the BF-110 is actually a fun plane to fly. And I can understand what people don't like, but see, I like the BF-110 in arcade and realistic. I think a lot of the hate for the BF-110 came from maybe history, but I remember when I used to watch the Mighty Jingles all the way back in, like, when he used to do his original War Thunder videos, he talked about the BF-110 being a pig of a plane, and you wanted to get rid of it as fast as possible before anything else. I wonder if that gave people a bad impression of the aircraft. This was the first aircraft I ever hit, I believe was the first German aircraft that I ever hit 10 kills with. Because it's just fucking amazing. Nowadays, this thing is so much fun to fly in arcade, racking up kills left and right, and is actually extremely durable in my experience, not only to fly with, but also to fight against. And in realistic battles, sure, it's a little slow, it's a little sluggish, and it has a really crappy climb rate, but it's still so freaking satisfying to fly that thing. It's got, I think it has 2 20mm cannons and 4 machine guns. Anyways, now, is this the new BF-110? No, it is not. Okay, so the BF-110 we had in the game now, I believe, is the BF-110 C4 or C1, something. That has now been replaced with the BF-110 C7. So it's just been a replacement model, kind of like they did with the Japanese BF-109E3 to the E7, or how, like, the A20G30 went to the A20G25, you know, stuff like that. It's not a new plane, it's a replacement plane. The other one's not hidden or anything. It's completely just been turned into this. So obviously the model is going to look different, and it looks fucking beautiful. The paint schemes, again, this is something I'm worried about. I love the paint schemes on the base BF-110 in the game now. I really hope that we get some that are equal to that, because this is definitely a new paint scheme here. It's equipped with 2 20mm MG-FFM cannons with 360 rounds and 4 7.92mm MG-17 machine guns with 4,000 rounds, as well as that single 7.92mm machine gun with 750 rounds there in the rear, aiming backwards. So, good. It still has the same armament. Thank freaking God. that's good. And it's probably still going to be able to carry... Hopefully, it can still carry those bombs, because that helps out in some events. It can. Okay. In fact, it looks like it can carry a shit ton of stuff. Alright, so this one can carry 12 50-kilogram bombs, 2 250-kilogram bombs, a single 500-kilogram bomb, 2 500-kilogram bombs, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, and a 250-kilogram bomb. So, lots of stuff to choose from there. Very nice. Okay, are we going to see... Yes, we're going to see the new BF-110s! I'm so excited, holy shit, this thing looks freaking amazing. Oh... Do you know how many BF-110s Gaijin had on their original planned release tree? Way back in the day, like, we're talking way the fuck back before tanks were released, or before tanks were even talked about, each of the nations, right on the webpage front, you could click on planned release trees, and each of the tech trees had this list of aircraft, you know, that had white aircraft and yellow names, or excuse me, white names and yellow names. I think yellow names were ones that were already in the game or something like that, and white ones were ones that were planned or vice versa, and then it had premiums on there as well. Well, the BF-110 section, they removed these, by the way, because they gave a reason why on one of the old Q&As, but fuck that. But the original German release tree, or a planned release tree for the BF-110s, you should have seen how many there were. There were, like, 15 or more BF-110s on that list. It was crazy. You had so many freaking variants, and now we're getting two? Well, at least that's what I was told. This one is at least one. So this is the BF-110 F2 variant. I'm curious to see what's different about this one, if anything. Battle rating 3.0, 11,000 RP, rank 2. It has 2 20mm MG-FFM cannons, 360 rounds, and 4 7.92mm machine guns, MG-17 MGs, with 4,000 rounds, as well as a 7.92mm rearward facing. So far, there's nothing different with this except maybe performance. I don't know. Maybe it can carry bombs, different types of bombs. Let's go ahead and see. There it is on the tech tree, guys. Oh, and there is a new BF-110. Oh! How long has the BF-110 been rank 2? Oh, I could have swore that used to be a rank 1. No, it was probably rank 2 for ages. Look at that, guys. It's 3. That's so fucking amazing. Oh, okay. Cool beans. All right, let's see. So there it is on the tech tree. Comes after the BF-110C7 and before the BF-110G2. Oh, man, another fucking one. Okay, please tell me what's new with this. Holy shit, okay, it can carry. All right, excuse me. Okay, anyways, let's see. So this thing can carry 12 50-kilogram bombs, two 250-kilogram bombs, a 500-kilogram bomb, two 500-kilogram bombs, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, and a 250-kilogram bomb, or added two cannon pods, or 12 RZ-65 unguided rockets. So this plane gets rockets, so that's what's new there, and also cannon pods. Now, I can see there in the offensive section for the ammunition that there is a grayed-out offensive 20mm, which tells me that the cannon pod, the dual cannon pods are 20mm cannons. I could be mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's what I'm going to guess. Which means that you can add this thing to have four 20mm cannons and four machine guns. Holy shit. Hell yes. As if the normal BF-110 wasn't badass enough in arcade battles, this thing's gonna fucking wreck. Ugh. And don't tell me about freaking flight performance, you know, downgrades, because in arcade, that doesn't matter. In arcade, you shoot to kill. Wait, where's the... Okay, well, it does matter, partially, but... And here is the third, or I guess technically second new BF-110, the G2. This thing has a very much different nose, and it looks like it has dual machine guns as a defensive turret, so I'm very curious to see what's different here. The BF-110 G2 is a rank 2, battle rating 3.3, costs 14,000 RP to unlock. Holy shit! Look at this thing's armament! This thing has two 20mm MG151 cannons with 750 rounds. That's the great 20mm cannon, not the shitty low-velocity one. It also has two 30mm MK108 cannons with 255 rounds. And the turret is a dual 7.92mm MG81 with 1,500 rounds. What the hell, guys? This is amazing! This is the freaking best update. Oh my god, can it carry any secondaries? There it is on the tech tree, as you can see, after the BF-110F2 and before the DO-217 ends. And it does, in fact, have the ability to carry a shitload of stuff. Oh my god, okay. Oh wait, shit, okay, I think I was actually told about these armaments here. Okay, so this can carry 12 50-kilogram bombs, two 250-kilogram bombs, one 500-kilogram bomb, two 500-kilogram bombs, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, a 1,000-kilogram bomb, and a 250-kilogram bomb, or it can equip one cannon. That one external cannon pod is a 37mm gun, or it can equip a dual cannon pod, which I believe I was told is actually 20mm cannons as well. So you could possibly have four 20mm cannons and two 30mm cannons, or two 20mm cannons, two 30mm cannons, and a 37mm cannon. This thing's going to be freaking crazy. You can also equip four WFR GR-21 rockets, which, or you can have two cannons and the four rockets, or the one cannon and the four rockets. So you can have the 20mm cannon pods and rockets, or the 37mm cannon pod and rockets. That's crazy. Now, these are only four rockets. Now, I don't remember what WFR GR rockets are. I don't know if those are the anti-tank rockets or the anti-air rockets. Somebody will have to tell me in the comments below. They're probably anti-ship. I don't know. Okay, moving along. What do we have now? Ah, right. Okay, this is the HE-177, the FX-1400. This is the Fritz 10 times 3. So mass 1,570 kilograms. Now, I don't exactly know how this bomb works in the game, but that's what the screenshot is showing, that it is now available for it. You get to carry three of them, and here's all the other bombs there if you're curious enough to look. So, new shit. Okay, moving on. Okay, now we're moving to the Russians. Now, this is the IL-28SH. I have no idea what is new about this thing. What's different between this and the IL-28? It has two 23mm cannons. Oh, wait, it doesn't have a turret? Is that what I'm seeing? This thing doesn't have a turret. It's 8.0 battle rating, rank 5, 130,000 RP required. Hold on a minute, I'm curious. I want to see what's different with this thing. Yeah, there it is. It doesn't list a turret, but the picture shows a turret. So maybe it does have the turret, but it's not working yet? I don't know. That's curious. What's different about this? Oh, look! You can equip four cannons on this thing. What, four cannons? You can put four 23. You can have six 23mm cannons on this thing. With that, the four have 500 rounds. That is overkill for a Russian plane. And there's all the other the armaments. I don't know if those are the same as the base IL-28 or not. So we're just getting another variant of the IL-28 that can basically up its forward-facing armament. That is amazing. All right, now we get to look at the best plane in the game, the Kai-32, which is a new Japanese light bomber, battle rating 1.7, rank 1, has 4,000 RP, as to be expected. It has a single pilot-controlled 7.7mm Type 89 machine gun with 135 rounds. It's a ton of ammunition right there. And you also get a dual 7.7mm Type 89 machine gun turret with 270 rounds there. And that's about it. So let's go ahead and take a look at what this thing can actually carry for payload. Obviously, isn't going to be much. There it is on the tech tree. So it's exactly where I expected it to be on the tech tree, right after the D3A1 and before the B5N2. And it can equip 9 50-kilogram bombs or 4 100-kilogram bombs. Damn, this thing's gonna kick serious ass. But hey, you know what? It's a new starter plane, and I have nothing against starter planes. I think starter planes are very interesting and nostalgic because that's where people are gonna be starting. Unless you, like, kick ass on a different tech tree and then gold your way through the Japanese tech tree or something. I don't know. I think that would be the only way you would avoid playing it. Okay, new Italian aircraft, guys. The RE-2000GA. So I had actually heard ahead of time that there was going to be a new Italian plane that wasn't the Rank 2 Premium. And I was like, okay, it's obviously going to be the RE-2001, right? They'll just, you know, each update release one of the REs, the Reggiani aircraft, so that we can slowly get closer to having a full line. Apparently that's not the case. It's just a separate 2000 variant. No idea what's different about the GA. It looks like it has the same two 12.7mm machine guns with 600 rounds. It's 7,900 RP at rank 1, so it's not a rank 2, and it has a 2.3 battle rating. There's obviously something different with it, but what exactly, I don't know. Let's see where it is on the tech tree. All right, it's located right after the RE-2000 Serie 1, and it has a higher battle rating, so maybe it has a better engine, so it's faster and has a better performance or something. Otherwise, why would they put it at a high... Is that seriously only going to be 800? Okay, hold on a minute. We'll get to that when we come to it. Okay. Well, the RE-2000GA can actually carry two 500-pound bombs. Or is that pound or kilogram? I don't know what Italy... I would imagine it's kilogram. And two 100-kilogram. Again, correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, now let's look at this beautiful user-made aircraft here, the IAR-81C. Battle rating 2.7, located at rank 2. It has two... German MG151 20mm cannons with 350 rounds and two 12... Wait, what? It has two American machine guns? Hold on a minute. It has two 7.62mm Browning machine guns with 1,400 rounds. I did not know that. I'm assuming it's all wing-mounted, the cannons and the machine guns, because I see nothing where they can fit in the nose. And now this one is still... I still consider this a little controversial. Personally, I do not think this should be on the Italian tech tree. No matter the reasons or, you know, whatever. I'm not complaining about it, but I'm just saying I feel like it was a bit cheap because every single Romanian plane in the game is on the German tech tree. And when we finally get a unique full-on Romanian aircraft, it goes on the Italian tech tree, not the German tech tree. Okay, regardless of their reasons, I still kind of think it should be on the German tech tree and not on the Italians. But the Italians have no Rank 2 Premium, and it's good to see that they have one now. Especially an aircraft like this. And yes, it says the price is 850 Golden Eagles. I don't know if that's going to be final, but that is way cheaper than I was thinking. There it is on the tech tree. Finally, a freaking rank 2 premium for the Italians. And yeah, it looks nice. If it actually is 850 when the patch goes live, then holy freaking shit, instant buy, because I was expecting to maybe be 1,300 or maybe 1,500 gold. Okay, and here we get to see... Okay, so it can carry bombs and rockets. Get a load of that. It can carry two 50-kilogram bombs, a 250-kilogram bomb, a 250-kilogram bomb, and two 50-kilogram bombs, two of the WFR-GR-21 rockets, or two of those same rockets and a 250-kilogram bomb. Nifty, nifty. Okay, what do we got next? Ooh, a new French aircraft, because of course. All right, this thing looks fucking weird. Holy shit. Okay, this is the LEO... 451 late. So it's another variant of another plane, but it looks so. Look at those engines, and it. Ooh, look at the cockpit. It looks like they just slapped a whole bunch of armor on some plane. At least that's what it looks like. Okay, so it's Battle Rating 3.0, rank 2, 14,000 RP required to unlock this. So another new low tier French aircraft. It has a single pilot controlled 7.5mm Mach 1934 machine gun with 1,500 rounds. And it has a 20mm Hispano 404 cannon with 120 rounds turret, which is that one you can see right there on the rear. And it also has it has a dual 7.5mm Mach 1934 machine gun with 1,500 rounds, presumably somewhere. And then it also has another single turret 7.5mm Mach 1934 machine gun with 500 rounds. And as for its payload, let's go ahead and take a look. Well, there it is on the tech tree. So it's located in a folder with the early variant, which makes sense. And here's what it can carry. So it can carry 16 of the 50 bombs, 7 of the 100s. Are these kilograms? These aren't kilograms. So it can carry 16 50 kilograms, 7 100 kilograms. What the fuck? One 100 kilogram and 6 200 kilogram? It's very hard to tell what is what here. Two 500 kilogram, one 100 kilogram, and four 200 kilograms, I think is what that one says. So those are your options there for that plane. And of course, here's the new F4U, the F4U-7, which is going onto the French tech tree as well. It is rank 4, battle rating 6.0, 85,000 RP requirement. Looks very snazzy, looks very futuristic compared to the early F4Us. It's equipped with four 20mm AN-M3 cannons with 984 rounds. That's basically it. It's very fast. Well, I mean, it's a Corsair. What do you expect? There it is on the tech tree. So it comes after the P-63C5 and before the F-8F-1B. So filling in that rank 4 section for their nation. And here's what it can carry. So it can carry a shitload of stuff. It can carry 10 of the 100... I'm guessing that's kilogram again. 10 250-pound bombs, 4 500-pound bombs, 3 1,000-pound bombs, 10 HVAR rockets, 10 of the T-10-140 rockets, 10 of the T-10-151 rockets, or the 114 SNEB, or Super Nintendo Enter Boner Type 23 rockets, which is crazy. So, there you go. Okay, and here, oh wow, okay, they're getting a new jet. The F-84G26RE. I was not aware of this, so they're getting another, shit. Well, fuck. They're getting another F-84, rank 5, of course, battle rating 8.0. Requirement for RP is 200,000. It has six 12.7mm M3 Browning machine guns. It's good to see those M3s again. I fucking remember when the F-8F-1 had M3s. And not M2s like they do now. Although, to be honest, I prefer M2s, but it's just a nostalgic thing. Anyways, 8.0 battle rating. Let's see what this thing has, probably for its payload armament. There it is on the tech tree, so it comes... wait, didn't they have another F-84? Oh, no, they didn't. The Italians are the ones that haven't had an F-84, isn't it? Okay, then... That was a mistake on my part. I thought the French were the ones that had the F-84, but it was actually the Italians. So now the French are getting their own F-84. Okay, right. All right, well, there you go. I corrected myself. and here's what it can carry. So it can carry two 100-pound bombs, two 250-pound bombs, two 500-pound bombs, two 1,000-pound bombs, 24 HVAR rockets, 32 HVAR rockets, 24 HVAR rockets, and two 100-pound bombs, 24 HVAR rockets, and two 250-pound bombs, 24 HVAR rockets, and two 500-pound bombs, 24 HVAR rockets, and two 1,000-pound bombs, or two Tiny Tims and 24 HVAR rockets. And that is everything for aviation right now. So lots of neat stuff in here. Basically, it seems like for aircraft, it's just sub-variants of already existing planes. So nothing, you know, like this plane here. This is entirely new and unique. You know, and these planes are unique too, but they're variants of already existing planes. So they're not exactly, that one's unique. They're not exactly, you know, fully new blown aircraft. But that doesn't bother me, especially when we're getting freaking two new BF-110s. Hell freaking yes. Plus a new P-40. Hell yes. There's another new plane. You know, so very nice. I like the planes. Now, I'm very eager to see the ground forces section of this list, which is what we're going to be taking a look at here now. Okay, so let's move on over to ground forces. And okay, so we're already going to be greeted with the T-32. Okay, this is not a new tank, but it is an updated model. Now, I'm very eager to see this because, well, wait, what is that over there? What is this symbol on the camouflage? What's that little gold, like, token thing? I don't know. I don't know what that is, but it's there. Anyways, if somebody knows what that is, tell me. Automatic camouflage battle. Oh, shit, they're finally... Oh, thank God, that's... Wait, what? Okay, yeah, okay. Fuck it, whatever, never mind. That's a discussion for another time. So the T-32 is an already existing tank in the game, but it's getting an updated model, and here it is. And it looks fucking gorgeous. She already looked gorgeous before, but now she looks better, in my opinion. The T-32 used to be one of my favorite United States tanks. In fact, it actually used to be my favorite tank in all of War Thunder. She was my grinder for the United States tech tree back in the day. She was in fucking penetrable. She was battle rating 6.7. Which may or may not have been too little. But then they completely fucked it up when they raised her not to 7.0, but to 7.3. And completely just screwed it up. Where constantly, at the time, when it was actually Cheat FS, was being used by every single fucking tank. And you couldn't do anything against anything. And you would just die from people shooting straight through the front of your turret. Now, however, she's 7.0, and she's very, very fucking easy to drive. Without just constantly being obliterated by, you know, Heat FS or, you know, Sabo and stuff like that. You still fight that stuff sometimes, but for the most part, I found in arcade and realistic, this thing's far more fun to drive nowadays. Of course, it has the biggest fucking weak spot in the history of any tank ever. It's lower plate, easily killable, one shot from even the smallest gun in the game just instantly obliterates this tank, which is why if you hide it, you are scary as all hell. And that gun is... Give me some. So yeah, there's nothing really else to talk about, but look at the new model. I think it looks great. I really do. So I'm happy with it. It's not like the IS-3, which got the IS-3M update. I swear to God, if they do that with the IS-2, I'm gonna fucking flip out if they do that in the future. The IS-2M needs to be a separate vehicle. It cannot be an upgrade for the IS-2 1944. It can't be an updated model. Don't give me that shit. The IS-2M is a full-on freaking upgrade. Okay. So, now. What's wrong? Okay, yeah, here we go. Alright, let's close that and move on. Alright, so here we have the XM-803, the new United States... rank 6 main battle tank, battle rating 9.0, 390,000 RP requirement. Wait a minute, if the dev server's open, that means the update's going to release very soon, and I don't have the M1 Abrams. I'm not going to fucking grind through the XM-803 just to get the Abrams when I'm so close to... Oh, fucking me. Shit. Fuck. I gotta freaking sell my soul or something. No. I've gotta freaking get off my ass here soon after this video and just ultra grind the rest of the freaking Abrams right now. Anyways, this vehicle has a 152mm XM150E5 gun launcher with 53 rounds, so it can fire ATGMs as well as tank shells. It also has the mounted 12.7mm machine gun with 1,000 rounds, which is, of course, not a 20mm autocannon. That's one of the differences. And it has a 7.62mm machine gun there in the turret, I believe. And of course, another difference with this vehicle, I believe, is its performance, its acceleration stuff. It's not as good as the MBT-70, I believe, according to the dev blog. Its armor protection is a little bit subpar. It's just another choice to pick from. Now, where did they... Oh my god, no, okay. They put it in... Okay, never mind. I don't have to rush on the M1 Abrams just yet. They put it in... They put it in a folder with the MBT-70. Thank fucking God. Okay, good. That makes sense. That means they're not going to force you to get it to get to the M1 Abrams. Fantastic. Awesome. So, but there it is on the tech tree. And here is what it gets. So by default, it actually comes with APFSDS, and you can also get what looks like a heat shell, smoke shell, and of course the ATGMs. You can go ahead and look at the penetration stats and stuff if you wish. All right, and... Oh, wait, no. Okay, well, yeah, okay, here we go. So here's the heat shells. Of course, everything's subject to change. Don't forget about that. And there's the ATGMs. Okay, and now we get to look at the XM1 General Motors, which is the new Rank 5 Premium for PC and PlayStation 4, because Gaijin are fucking... Anyways, so this is a Rank 5 Battle Rating 9.0. It's a Battle Rating 9.0, guys. That is disturbing. I don't know... I mean, I don't know how I exactly feel about that, because I thought that that was... I don't know. Anyways, well, I'll get onto that here after we look at it. So it's got a 105mm M68 cannon with 55 rounds. It's got a 12.7mm machine gun there mounted. It's also got a 7.62mm machine gun mounted. And it also has a 7.62mm machine gun in the turret. You can see all the ammunition counts there. Fast, maneuverable, of course. It's a prototype of the M1 Abrams. What do you expect? However, 9.0, any player... in existence, including the entirely new player base that's coming from the Xbox One with their exclusive Chrysler version, are going to be able to literally buy a top-tier tank straight out of the gate, and I bet, well, there it is on the tech tree, and I bet it comes equipped with APFSDS, and it does. It gets access to Sabo, Hesh, HeatFS, Smoke, and APFSDS. So, there's the Hesh shell. Here's the HeatFS shell. And there's the APFSDS shell. Now, it's not maxed here. It's not 9.7 battle rating, but it's 9.0. Okay. And literally, you can start playing the game yesterday and buy this pack. I thought it was strict, that Gaijin was strictly against the idea of allowing players, at least I thought this was the reason why there are no rank 5 premium jets, or there used to not be rank 5 tanks. There are now because there's a whole new rank, there's rank 6. But I thought the whole idea that they did that was because they didn't want players to buy into the big ass top tier vehicles. They didn't want the ability to just buy your way into, you know, M1 Abrams territory. That's literally what you're doing with the XM1. So, I don't know. It's, of course, going to be a kick-ass grinder, which is great, but I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that exactly. But I wouldn't feel as bad about it, honestly, if we had an official statement from Gaijin saying, like, they changed their minds on that or something, you know, and gave a reason. Okay, I heard about this. This thing is fucking amazing. Germany is getting a new armored car, the SDKFZ221, or SPZB41 variant. This is fucking awesome. So it's not the SDKFZ222. That would have been awesome. That's, you know, with the freaking 20mm autocannon on the top, hopefully someday. This is another freaking tank destroyer version, or anti-tank version. It's gray, so there's that. It's battle rating 1.3, rank 1, 4,000 RP requirement. It has a 28/20mm SPZB41 cannon with 60 rounds, so of course it's going to have a ridiculously high fire rate and probably a high penetration and kill rate, because it's German. But there it is. There's literally nothing else to freaking say. It's awesome to see this vehicle in the game. It is absolutely amazing to see it. It's good to see another armored car added to the game that isn't a collectible vehicle. Still waiting on the SDKFZ234/2, or excuse me, 234/3, though. That was in the files and had a fully fledged model way back before Festive Quest started. So I'm curious to see what they're waiting on that one with. If they're going to add it to the game or if it's going to be another collectible. I don't know. I swear to God, if it's a fucking Xbox One exclusive, I'm fucking done with this fucking game if they start doing that shit again. Moving on to the tech tree. So it's going to go before the Panzerjäger 1 at rank 1. So it's going to be the starter. Which I think it's a perfectly fine starter vehicle. It's of course going to have low armor protection and such. Which is to be expected from the type of vehicle that it is, and it is listed as a tank destroyer. And here's what it gets. So it gets composite rigid only, which, I mean, at Battle Ready 1.3, composite rigid is still going to absolutely wreck everything. Oh, my God. It's the Leopard 2A4. And it looks beautiful. Holy shit, it looks so freaking good. It looks so much better when you see it in-game as opposed to when you see the in-game model on the website, in my personal opinion. And, oh my God, okay, 120mm Rheinmetall L44 cannon, 42 rounds, and a 7.62mm MG3A1 machine gun on the top and in the turret, 6,500 rounds there. And basically, all the stats are God, so there you go, nothing else to look at. I cannot freaking wait to grind this thing out, holy shit. And it is, of course, going to go in the Leopard line. There, I saw somebody comment recently saying that they hope it's not in the Leopard line. They want it to be in the KPZ line, which I can understand their reason, or the reason they gave, I understand, but why would they put that not in the Leopard line? You know what I mean? It would make sense to not put it, or it would make no sense to not put it in the Leopard line. It would make absolutely no sense. I'm happy they put it here, because it's consistent. Leopard 1, Leopard A1A1, Leopard 2K, Leopard 2A4, you know, you have to work your way down the Leopard line. That's just my personal opinion. I don't know if people agree with me or not on that, but, well, there it is. Battle Rating 9.7, of course, it requires 390,000 RP to unlock. And here's what it gets. So, by default, it gets APFSDS, and it looks like its secondary is Heat FS. That's a great APFSDS shell. And holy God, that freaking Heat FS shell is ridiculous. Oh my God. Holy shit. This isn't a modification, is it? It isn't. What the hell, dude? I was freaking looking at that. Okay. So the Russians are getting a new top tier tank, guys. It's not just some bullshit modification. It is actually a new tank, and it's the T-62M1. So this was talked about in one of the recent Q&As, and so we knew it was coming to the game, but it was a matter of when and exactly what they were going to do. Because if you go to Google and you type in T-62M, there's actually a few different T-62s. That you can find. One of them looks like this, but looks nothing like it at the same time. This looks fucking awesome. So it's got all the additional armor on there and everything, and it looks like it's got ridiculously awesome looking smoke launchers. And it's got the 115mm U5TS cannon with 40 rounds, a 12.7mm machine gun, and a 7.62mm machine gun. Now, in my Russian tech tree right now, my T-62 has a talisman. I was kind of baited. I wouldn't say baited, but I was kind of pressured into getting a talisman for it. And it really wasn't a waste. I actually enjoy driving the tank. It just dies really easy, and the long reload time means I always end up with assists. If I don't kill the tank right away anyways, but the APFSDS shell is kick-ass anyway, so it's not like it fucking matters. So I may be tempted to unlock this thing and then put a talisman on it so I can have two talisman T-62s, because that would just be overkill. Battle rating 9.0, so it's a really high battle rating, and of course 390,000 RP cost at rank 6. And where does that fit on the tech tree? Fits right there. It comes at the very end of the medium tank line. So there's the T-62, and you can see the T-55A comes after it, and now the T-62M1 comes after the T-55A, and there isn't an arrow, so that means you can skip directly to the T-62M if there is more tanks added in the future that keep extending the length of the tech tree. So yeah, bang boom bosh, there you go. Or bish bash bosh, not bang boom bosh. What the fuck is that? We're 43 minutes in. Okay, I'm a bit whippy. One whole battle rating higher than the T-62, but I think with APFSDS, the T-62 is still going to hold its own. And it's ammunition, so by default, it gets APFSDS, and then it looks like it gets another APFSDS, a much better shell. Then, of course, it also gets its Heat FS. Then it gets high explosive, and this thing can actually also fire ATGMs. I completely forgot about that. Holy shit. Okay, well, there you go. It can fire ATGMs as well. Which, of course, are ATGMs, so what do you expect? Now, I don't know if that's first or second generation. I'm going to guess second generation. Does it say in here? It's a semi-automatic for guidance system. I don't know if that means first generation or second generation. Somebody will have to tell me in the comments. And moving along, Oh, nice. Okay. Now, I didn't know what this was when I saw it on the list of vehicles, or the leaked vehicle list. I didn't know what they meant at first when they said Vickers. I was thinking, oh, okay, so it's the Vickers main battle tank AA variant. But no, it's actually the fucking Vickers, like, early freaking pre-war tank that now has four freaking machine guns on it. That is actually cool as hell. I wasn't expecting this. Whoops, shit. Hold on a minute. When the British Ground Forces tech tree was teased way back in the day, I actually was planning to make a video on what we could see in the game, and I was thinking the reserve was actually going to be one of the Vickers light tanks. That's what I thought one of the reserves was going to be. It wasn't, obviously. But at least we're getting it in some form in the game now with the Mark 6A AA, a rank 1 battle rating 1.0 anti-aircraft vehicle with 2,900 RP required, has four 7.92mm machine guns with 3,600 rounds. And there it is on the tech tree. So, and obviously, I think, yep, okay, so here's something. So the Daimler AC Mark II armored car used to be here. So basically what they've done is they've moved that over to the third line, which now comes after the Tetrarch Mark I and before the Valentine Mark I. And they've replaced it with the Vickers Mark 6A anti-aircraft vehicle. So it's good to see more AA for the British tech tree. I'm still waiting on the Centaur. That was actually my highest requested AA vehicle for the British before their tech tree was even released. We still don't have it. Maybe as a collectible premium, please. That'd be pretty cool. And here we get to see its ammunition. So it's got default universal APIT and APT. So just like you're firing aircraft machine guns, because that's basically what you are firing. Okay. And then, of course, we've got the Centurion Mark V AVRE, which is the new Rank 5 bundle premium for the British tech tree. Looks very, very good in the game. It has a 165mm ORD BL 6.5-inch L9A1, holy shit, demolition charge projector. It's not just a gun, it's a demolition charge projector. With 53 rounds, and it also has two 7.62mm machine guns with 4,500 rounds. It's got the explosive reactive armor packages on there. And yeah, that's about it. There's nothing else to really say about it. Battle rating 7.0, rank 5. It's a premium. You can get it for $49.99, I believe, along with some Golden Eagles and some premium time and stuff. So, normal stuff. There you go. That is the first British rank 5 premium ground vehicle in the game. Never forget. And there it is on the tech tree. So, looks great. And there it is. So, it only gets one shell. It gets Hesh. You be the judge of whether or not you think that's... Holy shit. The Hesh actually goes... Oh, no. Never mind. Okay, no. That's at different angles. I was like, wait a minute. The Hesh actually increases its penetration value at ranges. But I was reading it the wrong way. Here's, of course, the second new British anti-aircraft vehicle. The oh-so-beautiful... Chieftain Marksman, which is a new rank 6 battle rating 8.0 anti-aircraft unit. It has 380,000 requirement for RP, two 35mm KDA cannons with 500 rounds. It's just the British Gepard, only not as good. It obviously has the upgrade in the armor department, but it's a huge fucking target, and the guns are so spread out from each other. This thing's going to be weird as hell to drive, but hey, you never know. I guess we'll find out. So that is actually another one of the highly requested vehicles for the British tech tree. It comes right there at rank 6 after the Falcon and before nothing, so they now have a new top tier, and that'll make people happy. And here's its ammunition that gets default, which you can see there. And then it gets 35x228 MSBK, okay, which is looks like high explosive and AP shells. Or you can have the opposite, which is mostly API shells with HEI. And then the last one here, that's Japanese, we don't want to look at that just yet. The last one here is HVAP, okay, so your anti-tank, basically. Okay, and then of course we've got the Japanese Type 90, holy fucking hell, is it a beauty as well. It has a 9.7 battle rating, 390,000 RP requirement, the 120mm Type 90 L44 cannon with 40 rounds, and a 12.7mm mounted machine gun. It's fucking beautiful looking. I cannot wait to get this thing. Oh my god, it's going to be so good. What the hell is that sound? Is that my air conditioner? I don't know. I keep hearing dinking noises. Yeah. So again, another long-awaited vehicle on the Japanese tree. This was another one of those vehicles that a lot of protesters against people that wanted it said it would never come to the game, at least not for a long time. Well, remember I said the M1 Abrams probably wasn't going to be coming to the game for a long time, and literally the next update it came out. So I was not at all going to say that the Type 90 wouldn't be a possibility, and sure enough, here it is. And on the tech tree, there it is, comes after the Type 74, as you would expect it, rank 6. Nothing else to point out about it. Damn it, they still have no rank 5 premium. Okay, moving on. And here's what it gets. So by default, it gets a fucking amazing APFSDS shell. Holy shit. 540 millimeters of penetration, and its Heat FS shell is god as well, because this tank is just badass, apparently. Holy nuts. Alright, and yes, guys, the French are getting a new main battle tank, the AMX-40. Okay, I saw a lot of comments in the past couple days complaining that the French weren't getting any new top-tier tank. They are getting one, the AMX-40. Battle rating 9.0, rank 6, 390,000 RP requirement. The AMX-40 is equipped with the 120mm GIAT CN120-25 G1 cannon with 40 rounds. It also gets a 20mm cannon and a 7.62mm machine gun. That cannon does not look mounted, so it looks like it's there in the turret, so that might be a letdown. But either way, beautiful freaking looking tank. I just can't wait to play all these tanks. Holy nuts. 8.7 second reload rate and all that, like I said, stats subject to change, but you can go ahead and look at them if you want. And on the tech tree, it is not located after the MX-30s. It's actually located after the AMX-50 Tsubase. I probably pronounced that wrong. They're kind of doing there's another tech tree in the game that does this as well, where it's a vehicle you think it would come after the other ones, but it actually doesn't. That's not a problem for me at all. Not like it matters though, because I'm still less than halfway through the French tech tree, because I've still not touched them since release day. I know, sue me. Someday, hopefully when I get the AMX-30, don't get the AMX-30, it sucks. I don't care, I'm going to get it anyways, someday. Moving along, it by default has an APFSDS shell, which there you can see its stats, and of course Heat FS. A good Heat FS shell, it looks like, for high penetration. And that seems to be it for ground forces, guys, so yay, we've got ourselves a lot of new vehicles and beautiful model updates. This is, of course, just vehicle content. There's plenty of other content that's coming as well, changes and stuff. And also from the videos that are in the dev blogs, it sounds like we might be getting a lot of new gun sounds, at least for the American M2 Browning machine gun. And I also heard a different sound for the German cannons. So I'm very curious to hear those for myself in the game. It would be awesome to hear them in the videos, but Gaijin unfortunately does music over every single one of their videos, so it's hard to really hear anything about the vehicle itself. It'd be really nice, however, if they did like what they did way the fuck back in the day when they, I think it was like one of the first times they actually updated the gun sounds. Remember when they did a whole dev blog on that? And they had each of the videos where they showed the original sound and the new sound. They should do that again if they're going to update a whole bunch of sounds. They did that with the ground vehicle gun sounds, but those weren't new gun sounds. They were just new, like, immersive sounds. They're actually still the same exact fucking gun sounds. I'd like to hear something new for aircraft, especially fucking British 7.7s and the French 7.5s, please. They sound the exact same as they always used to. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Again, sorry I couldn't actually show you these on the dev server themselves, but, this will have to do for right now. Thanks to the person, again, that provided me with these screenshots, and I will see you in the next upcoming War Thunder content video, unless they decide to drop the update tonight, which I doubt, but hey, you never know. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Kiss, kiss, boom, boom. Cry.